Loving you the way I do. I know we're gonna make it.
You both have to go. No, I don't care if it hurts your feelings. They have to go.
So, what do you think of the bows?
You love them.
Oh, good. Because they just look so plain, and I thought, you know, bows. They're too much, aren't they? You hate the bows. Oh, God, you hate the bows.
No, we like the bows. We just had to get to know the bows.
Good. Well, they're going to cost an extra $50, but I thought they're worth it.
Yeah!
So, Carrie, have you thought about what you're going to say for your maid of honor speech?
Oh, it's a toast, right? It doesn't have to be a speech, does it?
Oh, no, it doesn't have to...
Oh, Denise. No, don't do this. Don't start crying. Oh, Denise. Oh, I know this is a really emotional week for you, but you gotta pick your spots, honey. But yesterday you cried over two fried eggs on a piece of toast.
I know, they just look so perfect together. My wedding day will be the happiest day of my life. My wedding day will be the happiest day of my life. My wedding day. Okay, better now.
So, when's your brother coming to town?
Oh, you mean Danny, my brother who's engaged?
Yeah.
Tomorrow? Oh, and he's engaged.
I just asked a question.
Come on, Shannon. No one's buying it. We all know he was the one.
That was over 5 years ago.
I've moved on.
And on and on and on. Don't worry, Denise. I'm sure Shannon can distract herself with someone. Between the band, the ushers, the caterers, some guy's got to be drunk enough to look past these bows, which I love.
Look, if I want to have fun, I'm going to have fun.
I'm not the one biting the dust.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means nothing.
Shannon?
Well, I'm just saying, Ryan's like all the other guys in this town.
I mean, we know them too well.
I mean, he's great, but why do you have to marry him?
Well, I don't expect you to understand.
He's hungry.
It's not something you can just put into words. It just feels right.
Swimming, six geese a laying. Richard?
Five golden rings.
Well, aren't you just the ghost of Christmas poopy?
Sorry I'm late, but we were out catching snowflakes on our tongues.
You know that no two snowflakes are exactly alike?
Or tongues.
Here you go, Christmas poopy. Two Sunday strips to color.
Ooh, is that fruitcake? Oh, I love fruitcake.
Well, you are what you eat.
Well, Shelly, take that fruitcake with you. I got two more from last year.
Thanks. Ooh, heavy. Feels delicious. Richard, I'm standing under the mistletoe.
Actually, they were out of mistletoe. You're standing under cilantro.
Oh, what do people do under cilantro?
They say goodbye.
Okay, goodbye.
Bye.
Oh, it works.
The previews.
Me neither. I love the previews. In fact, I enjoy being the theater cut-up. Last week after a preview, I yelled out, must miss!
I think that I was in that theater. That was really funny.
Yeah, I got a good laugh. Let me just check my messages before we go.
Follow anywhere.
feminine wiles, you know. Like that girl over there in the bait shop, you know. She's the kind of gal you see all over the place.
Oh,
all I know, she's...
Hey, that's a... It's a her. Christy, sir. Dale, this guy.
I know you. Hey, Dale, nice to see you.
Nice to see you, too. Oh, that's you?
Yeah.
Employee of the month. That's great.
All month.
Wow.
You know, you were so good the other night.
Oh.
You really were.
Thank you.
And, I felt so bad about what I said and the money and the...
Oh,
it was really
please
too...
don't. Just forget about that, okay? Because you were right. It's not about the money. It's about the music and the songs, and that's... we're recording a song in a real studio here in Nashville.
Look at you!
That means, looks like I'm gonna be around for a while.
What can I help you with today?
Oh, we're just here doing some shopping, picking
okay.
up some various right. sundries and...
We got them.
Yeah, you got a lot of stuff here. I can use a fishing pole.
Okay.
This one right here, that's good. Big old pole, I like that. I like the big one, good and long.
Okay.
And some of them large suckers, maybe, a couple medium suckers, a couple of fat heads. Well, you know, if you're employee of the month, you can probably set me up real good in that department.
I think you are a dirty man. I do. I think you are up to no good. Dirty dirt. Dirty dirt, scallion. Yeah. I gotta take my break now. You know, it is too bad because... I was really starting to fall for you.
What?
Another granddad, Santa?
Yeah.
Yeah? Got a name?
Yeah.
So what do you do, you know, after the holidays, I mean.
Well, nothing till March, and then I'm the Easter Bunny.
Oh, another?
Yeah, why not?
Merry Christmas. Not a big talker.
No, not really.
Buy you one?
Why not?
Happy New Year. You're pretty regular for a Santa.
No, it's not that big a fucking deal. It's just a job, you know what I mean? I'm an eating, drinking, shitting fucking Santa Claus.
Prove it.
DVD.
You know this perfect girl your whole life, but you never go for.
She doesn't take me seriously.
Don't lick the silverware.
It's too late. Forget about it.
Sunday. Let's go out.
Okay. Do you hear about Zach's date with Abby? He's going back to all the women in his life. Find out why he can't hold a relationship.
Well, that's retarded.
You're cheap and dirty.
Sleazy dirty or...
Dirty dirty.
You don't... Listen!
Women like sexy men.
Pedal. Get away from me!
I'm gonna miss this. You and me talking over the fence.
Lucky 13. A love story about going backward to move forward. Get Lucky 13 on DVD March 15th.
Our book says he's not getting late.
You're on.
I am successful, powerful, handsome, happy.
Newly elected Congressman Evan Baxter's life...
What are we gonna do?
Change the
world! That's right!
...was going exactly as planned.
There he is, the big kahuna.
I think I have to do the dance.
Do the dance.
Until he met someone... with a plan of his own.
Who are you?
I'm God. Flood's coming, and I want you, Evan Baxter, to build an ark.
Yeah.
Hey, Dad, look, two doves.
Well, today must be my lucky day.
Now, no matter where he turns...
Those animals are following me.
See, if you had an ark, you'd have a place to put them all.
No matter what he does.
Wow, what's with the scruffle, mountain man?
Whenever I shave, the beard grows right back in.
Evan, what happened? Did you fall in a mine shaft? Did you just come out of a coma?
No.
Were you attacked by a werewolf?
There's just no escaping.
Obviously, the stresses of this office have proven too much for you.
His destiny.
I lost my job, everything. Why are you doing this? Why me?
You want to change the world, son. So do I.
Here we go. Gentlemen, I have come up with a little construction project for us this weekend.
Oh!
The whole weekend?
Oh!
Yes. Maybe a couple weekends after that.
You're talking about building a boat.
It might be something fun for the family. Be great in case it floods or something.
From the director of Bruce Almighty...
Go! Go!
...comes the next chapter in the almightiest story of them all.
I know that this doesn't make any sense. I just want you to trust me.
Dad, I'm with you.
Me too.
Is that a llama with a hammer?
Let's finish this sucker.
This summer...
His name is Evan Baxter, but now he goes by New York's Noah. Heaven's Evan, the weirdo with a beardo.
When it comes to saving the world...
What's up?
...some assembly may be required.
Let's go! Thanks.
I can't even get my cat to use the litter box.
People! The flood is imminent! Is it too much to ask for a little precipitation?
Evan Almighty.
Everybody, hang on!
Held my breath as a last.
I love you.
I love you, too.
I didn't do a great job raising my little brother and sister. Most people would agree that at least one of them is unstable.
I heard you're a big photographer.
I take glamour shots of transvestites.
Everything okay?
Jay had an accident. He's gonna be okay. Maury's gonna bring him home for dinner.
I think I'm gonna stay in the attic.
Hey, Maury, what's up?
I just don't think this is the ideal time for you to come home.
Hi,
Jay. His head's misshapen. Is it a condition?
Okay. Coming through.
You know what they say, Maury? Loosen your belt a bit. Loosen your robe.
Well, you don't want to see that. It has been months since I've had a bowel movement. That's a true story.
You're psychotic, pal. Just like the rest of your family.
Yes, but we're nicer than you.
What doesn't kill you makes you so much stronger, stronger. Can you feel this pain rushing through these veins, driving me insane, but
time, but I had no idea that you're so brave, honey. I'm so proud of you.
Really? Because I was actually having second thoughts.
Oh, no, hon. I think, you know, the doctor said they need you to stay here for a couple days for, observation. I think that's a real good idea.
But, I don't think you really understand, okay? Some of the people in here are really messed up. I don't think my roommates left the room in weeks.
I think we better leave it up to the doctor's discretion, you know? We've tried, and they're professionals. They can help you in ways that we can't. And I think it's, I think it looks like a real nice place. Right, George?
Take your hand out of my pocket!
Yeah. When can I join?
Just an ocean of pixels in a dog's eyes, Pam.
Hey, Dad, how you doing?
I'm good, Kyle. You shouldn't mess with your mother like that.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
What'd y'all dig up over there?
The usual, Dad, just a lot more of it. You know, RPGs, AKs, a lot of Russian junk left over from the 80s.
I'd trade that M4 for one of those Russian AKs any day of the week.
Yeah, I'll run that up the flagpole,
well,
sir.
Anyway, I think both of you deserve a medal or something.
Yeah, Kyle's so awesome. His freaking dog's a hero.
Hey, feet off the table. No cussing in this house, please.
I didn't cuss, Mom.
Cut it out.
Hey, Mom, I gotta go, okay? I love you.
Oh, all right. Well, okay. Bye. We love
safe.
You.
Through these veins.